in Google Sheets, supposing you want to have a starting day and then calculate all of the other days in the month, and then also work out automatically what day of the week it is, and then highlight, say, the weekends, Saturday and Sunday, in a different color. So let's do that. Just to test it, I'll show you, first of all, supposing instead of January 1st, 2023, supposing we start with August 1st in 2024. You can see that the Saturday and Sunday are down here. It's calculated that those are the days which are the weekend days. Let's do another one. Let's go for September 1, 2025. And once again, you can see how the weekends are highlighted in a different color, and it's also worked out all of the days of the month. So how do we do that? Let's begin with a brand new spreadsheet. And we'll just begin with our first date. Now, what I'm going to do is just go equals that plus one. And Google Sheets, by default, will assume that that means one day after, not 1 hour, but one day after January 1. And so if we carry that formula down to the bottom here, the 31 days in January, there it is. So all we're really doing is just calculating the previous number plus one. So if I change that date to February 1, 2023, it does that calculation again. So what about the day here? Well, that's just going to use the text formula. So we go text equals the previous cell, and then we want to have the date, but we want to have it three letters, and so that will be the three-day abbreviation, mun, tu, wed, that sort of thing. Okay. And the autofill has already calculated that. So just to show that that all worked, you see that February 1st is a Wednesday. What if we were to go February 1st, 2025? You see that that has changed that to a Saturday, and it's changed all of those dates. So that's all based on this starting date here. So you only need to change that starting date, and it will calculate everything else. Now, for the conditional formatting of the dates, this is a little bit tricky. So we'll start with this cell, and by default, if we hit format, conditional formatting, it's going to assume, okay, if this cell is not empty, then format it. Well, actually, we don't want to do if it's not empty. What we want to do is we want to say from A2 to the bottom of the B row. So that's A2 colon to B. And what we wanted to do is to say, instead of if it's not empty, we want to go down to custom formula. Now, the custom formula, the format is going to be a bit unusual. First, let's just do it just for Saturdays. And we're going to say, if B2 equals, and then we've got to put it in double quotes, Saturday. So the custom formula is, if B2 is Saturday, then highlight it. And we'll just click done there for the moment. So that's close to what we want, but we actually want it to be for Saturday and Sunday. And so what we're going to do here is we're going to say $B2, and that will lock in the $B and say anything in that column, that's what we want to highlight as well, and equals Saturday, and we hit done. So we're almost done, but what about the Sunday? We need another formula to say equals Sunday. So we could create a new formula, add another rule. But in fact, what we actually want to do is we want to say if B2 equals Saturday or if it equals Sunday. Now, the way we do that is instead of using the if command, which is what the B2 equals Saturday, we're going to use the or command, the or formula. And we're going to say either if B2 equals Saturday or $B again, 2, equals Sunday, and then you can see that that is still red because I haven't completed this formula. There's something missing, which is the close parentheses. As soon as I close them, then we are done. Customizing dates in Google Sheets. And by the way, if you wanted to do up to column C, then all you need to do is make this C as well. Okay?